Today I'm gonna show you how you can get all 18th larval tier in the game. If you don't know, larval tier are the items that you're gonna need to rebirth, to reset all your points in this game, and in total there are 18, and I'm gonna show you how you can get every single one of them really easy. The first one is so easy to get from the Aegel Lake South. You have to be to this location, it's very near to the point that you just started the game, and back there you're gonna see on that top of the cliff, you're gonna see that NPC, that enemy standing there. It's a really easy to beat one, but it's gonna be a bear after you're gonna defeat the first one. But again, that bear is not that hard to defeat, depends what level you are. Definitely after you're gonna defeat this bear, I don't know why I'm struggling so much, we're gonna move straight to the next one. So this will be the first larval tier that you can get. Now let's go to the second one. The second one, it will be in the village of the Albinaurix. I don't want to make 2 hour long video, and if you don't know how to reach a position in this game, don't matter if it's this village or if it's something else, I have a video on my channel exactly how you can be there. So I'm gonna assume that most of you already know how to be in this position. And the second one will be right over here to this dead NPC between those coffins. For me, it's already, I already loot that item, but definitely it's gonna be there, 100% sure. So this will be the second one, to the village of the Albinaurix. Now let's go to the third one, and the third one, it's pretty close. You'll have to be to the Liurnia Lakes, and we're gonna start to the Folly of the Lakes from the near to the church, Rose Church, and just go. Everything is a little bit fast forward, not too fast because I don't want to get you lost. I'm gonna show you the map every step of the way. And you'll see that lobster, that big lobster. And yes, like always, this will be the location. Like always, this lobster is gonna be transformed into something else after you wanna defeat it, him. Use your better, your best shots, your best armor, I don't know. It's gonna be transformed into this scion. Pretty aggressive little bastard, but if you are careful enough, you can defeat this guy. I don't know why I didn't have my good incantations, but I still managed to defeat him. Pretty aggressive little bugger. And this will be your third larval tier after you're gonna defeat this guy. Just let me show you. It will not appear again after you're gonna defeat him. And the third one, it's on your way. Now, let's go to the fourth one. Some of them you have to defeat some guys, some of them you have to buy, some of them you just grab them really easy. So you have all the option in the world for these items. Now the next one, it will be in the Kyld region, right over here to the Kyld Highway South you want to be. And from the Kyld Highway South, you'll want to go straight to that point that you are seeing, go on the edge of that cliff. Don't worry, again I'm gonna show you the location. And here you're gonna see some NPCs, and the last one, the one from the back, it's gonna be transformed into another giant, into a giant, this one. I think this one was the easiest one to defeat because it's so slow. And depends what level you want, what sword you want to use. I have the Radahn sword, but you will see that later in the game I'm gonna use other type of swords because this is not good enough for me. And yes, this will be your fourth larval tier. And let's go to the fifth one. This is the location, exact location where you want to be. Now let's go. You will have to be to the edge of the capital, to the rampart, to the outer wall, exactly where we are seeing right now. You have to pass the grand lift of Decatus, and from the location that you just saw on the map, you'll just want to go to travel on this road. This is basically a road right there, and you'll see some ruins. This NPC for me was really easy to beat. I changed my sword, I put another magical sword, but again this one was pretty easy because I didn't let him to transform. You're gonna see what I did there. Now I just cast all my spells really fast until it has the chance to attack me. And this will be our fifth one. I think it's the fifth one. I hope I will not lose count. And let's go to the sixth one. Again, some of them you have to defeat enemies, some of them you can take them really easy. This is will be another one that we have to defeat enemies. If you'll want to be to the volcano manor, if you don't know how to reach this location, I have a video exactly how you can be here, but maybe some of you again are already here to the road of inquisition and just want to go down from that road of inquisition, and you'll see another enemy right over here, the flaming one, the one in flames, and it's gonna transform into a tall monster, really huge animal. Okay, you grab me, you're gonna eat me with your worms. Oh my god, how disgusting is this? Worms, nice. Who doesn't like worms? And with the same sword, the feather or the wing of Astel is called this sword, I think. And you're gonna get the sixth one. The seventh one, let me show you. It's gonna be in the inner consecrated snowfields. A pretty hard to reach location, something at the end of the game. The second part of the snowfield, you have to unlock the hidden path of the consecrated snowfield. And you will want to go from this place. Again, I have a video on my channel exactly how you can be there from the capital. And from that location, I have to change my suit for this one. This was the hardest one. So if you want to skip one, skip this one. This will be the hardest one to get, definitely. You have to defeat a bear. And I'm a pretty high level, I didn't know what to use, but finally I found the perfect blade to defeat those guys. And you will see three NPCs right over there on the map where I just showed you. And all those three, they're gonna sit there. One it's buried in the snow, and the one that it's in the snow, it's gonna be the bear. Now, again, I had to change my suit, my weapons, because this thing is so aggressive and so strong. You don't have the time to hit him. Now, I now have my best armor, the Veteran's armor set. If you don't know how to get it, again, I have a video on my channel. And I took another sword. Also, this sword is on my channel. And I stay very close to the back feet of this bear. And I just summon my best incantation and my best sword spell. Basically, this is how I defeat this one. And you'll get your next larval tier. The seventh one. Now let's go to the eighth one. I hope I will not lose count. The eighth one, it will be right over here to the Siofra River. This is the underground location that you can reach pretty early in the game from the Siofra River well. And let me just show where you have to be, to that whispering woods, or what is that? You just saw it on the map, and you want to follow my path. Here you're gonna find a merchant, and this merchant is gonna sell you the 8th one. For this one, you don't have to fight. I told you, some of them are really easy to get. It's not a must to fight those NPCs if you don't like to. I just want to clear them, bro. Look at that guy. Just look at him. Okay, go down. With the crab. Crab people. I think if I am not wrong, this will be the 8th one. You are right over here. And go straight ahead and jump down there to get your 8th or 9th. No, my 9th. No, 8th. This will be your 8th. Now, here is gonna be your merchant where you can buy that item. Some really awesome items it has, this one. And take it, this one, the larval tier. Now, let's go really fast to the 9th one. We are at the half of the video. The 9th one, it will be from the Necron Eternal City, a similar location. Necron Eternal City, this will where we're gonna start. The next one, it will be pretty easy to get, so just go inside that building on the right after you're gonna exit that area, just right over here. And it will be right over there. You don't have to fight anyone, but you know, I like to clear my way. This will be your next, and the 9th one. Now, you will want to go outside to that door for the next one. You don't have to change location. I told you the next one will be pretty easy to get. Okay, so those annoying skeletons. And for the 10th one, you'll just want to get the same location, exact the same location. You'll want to get outside and go on the left, go between those buildings right over here. And here go on the right, keep going. Okay, and go on the right. It's gonna be right over here, the 10th one I think it will be, yes, at this NPC. Trust me, it's gonna be there. I already loot that item, but it's gonna be there. Now let's go to the 11th. And basically now we're gonna have two of those larvae tier, because you're gonna fight with your mimic tier. A really easy method of how you can fight with your mimic tier is to, I don't know if it still work after the update, go naked, go without any armor, and before the fight will start, here is gonna be the NPC, the mimic tier that you have to fight, and before the fight will start, you'll put your clothes on and you'll try to defeat that guy, because the NPC that you're gonna fight, this one, it's gonna be basically a copy of you. You're gonna fight you. So yeah, and here you're gonna take two, so the 11th and the 12th. I hope I pronounced that right. 11, 12. Okay, now let's go to the 13th, to the ancestral woods. It's gonna be the next one. Just jump here and go on the right. Nope, go on the right. So from that mimic tier, you're gonna get two. Lucky. Six more to go. You don't have to stay and fight those guys, but again, those are so annoying and they will follow me with those bows. And that's why I decided to defeat them. The twins. Silver tier. Okay. Now, you just want to keep going to the edge. And from this edge, you'll just want to go straight ahead to this broken wall. And you'll see a ball. A big ball that we have to defeat. Not hard at all. You can do it very easy. But you're gonna have some enemies right over here that they're gonna attack you, but be careful not to die. Three of them, I think, or two. Two of them, probably. And this will be our third one. The last two, they're gonna be the most, not difficult, but you have to work a little bit more to get them. Now, you will want to be, let me show you, this is the location. You'll want to be to the King Realm, to the road to Manor. I hope I pronounced that right. And to this location, you'll want to go here, to the Caria Manor. I'm gonna show you exactly how you can get your 14th one. Sorry, my English is not perfect. Now here you're gonna have to just to run, don't fight anyone. Do exactly what are you seeing right now. Those hands, they're gonna attack you, trust me. And you want to go a little bit on the left and to enter to that building right here. And also here you have to fight someone in order to reach the location. I'm gonna show you what you have to fight. Go on the left. I think you have to fight. We're gonna see. Keep going up. You will see a sight of grace right over here. Take it, obviously. And just get outside. Go to these towers. Then go on the right, straight ahead, and on the left, I think you have to go. Yeah, I know, a lot of working for this one. but it will worth it because here you're gonna have to, you can buy more things. This one, it will be a seller. For me, it's gonna be dead, but also you can have it, depends where you are with the game. You can find him dead or alive, depends. Now you're gonna have to take another grace manor upper level and just go outside. Keep going, don't fight those enemies. You're gonna see a lot of those that are guarding those that gate. Just fight, run. Keep running to those stairs. I know I have to give you the full guide for this one because it's not that easy to reach. And yes, here we have to fight a knight, if I remember correctly. Definitely here we have to fight a boss in order to get to this location. And here is gonna be another grace that we have to take, the Royal Moon Gazing Grounds. Definitely want to get this one. And from that one, you will see a chair that is down. Where you see that chair that is down, let's see where it is. It will be a gate right over here. And from that gate, you'll want to go on the left to the Three Sisters. This is the place basically where you can find the Rani's quest. And you don't want to go to the Rani's quest. You all just want to go on the left. Those are the towers of the Rani. Keep it on the left, on the edge. And keep going until you'll have to jump. Okay, you'll see that building right over there, that stone wall. Just jump down there. Okay, nothing to that bug. And now you're gonna see someone screaming. Depends where you are with the story. Just jump down. Be careful not to fall because it's pretty difficult. Continue, jump down, and you'll see that hole. You'll see a hole in the ceiling. Okay, right over here. And you'll see a ladder. Take this one. As you can see, some soldiers are down there. And for me, that NPC right now is dead, but you can get his bell bearing. Those soldiers will not attack you. The Pidas bell bearing. If it will be alive, you can buy from him. And also from this one, you'll have a nice surprise. You're gonna get the Dolores, the sleeping arrow. A really, really good summon, spirit summon. And from this location, you'll want to go to the Table of the Lost Grace. If you want to use that to get that larvar tier, just teleport to your Table of the Lost Grace and offer those old ladies the bell bearing. It will be easy as that. It's gonna be right over here, and you can buy more than one item. Again, this will be a little good surprise in this video. We are almost there, four more to go beside this one. So this will be your 14th one, and you can buy that. Let me show you. Bell bearing shop 1, 2 PDS bell bearing, and here we go. You'll have a lot of items that you can take. The celestial dew, which can be used to the Church of Vows, really important item, and the larvar tier, and a lot more items. Now let's go to the 15 one, and that one is gonna have to do, and you'll have to do another little quest, not something very, very hard. Basically it's pretty easy, if I have to admit. And let me just show you, you'll just want to go to this location. And on that top hill, if I remember correctly, you'll see the shack of the artist. And from that shack of the artist, you will have to start the painting tutorial. The painting, not tutorial, sorry, the painting, the painting quest, sorry. The painting quest, the resurrection, it will be called. In total are 7 different painting quests in this game. And this will be just one of them that you can take that larval tier. Pretty awesome, right? But okay, we have to travel some a little bit. But I just wanted to show exactly how we can get there. Right over here we'll have another grace to the artist shack right here on this location. I just show you some grace points that you can take and just start the quest. Go click on the painting, and after you're gonna click on it, you're gonna start the quest resurrection painting, and from this one you're gonna get as a reward after you're gonna find the artist the larval tier. You want to start again from the Royal Moon Gazing Rounds, the place where you just defeated that boss in the Caria Manor, at the Rani's place, but you don't have to go on the left to the Three Sisters, you want to go on the right. So this will be basically the location where you just have been to get the 14th one, and now the 15th larval tier is gonna be on the right, and also with that painting solution. Also now you're gonna complete that guide from the painting resurrection. You just want to travel and travel behind the Caria Manor castle. I think it's a castle right here. Behind Caria Manor it's called. And on the right side you're gonna see some graves right here. And the artist, it's gonna stay after. You'll see this rock, this big rock. Go on the right. And from this rock, you just want to see the artist right over here. After you're gonna see it, it's gonna drop the loot items. You're gonna get a really awesome armor set, the juvenile scholar cap, scholar robe, and the larval tier 1. Nice, right? And also you're gonna get a really awesome summon from this. Then I'll be Nauric Ash. Now the last three will be in the same location, so easy to get from the Noxtella Eternal City. You're gonna start the journey on the underground city. Again, I have the complete guideline of how you can be here if you don't know. From the Noxtella Eternal City, you just want to go up on those stairs, keep it on the right. At this moment you don't want to fight anyone. Now climb the stairs again, go on the right to this little bridge, and you'll see that big ball. That big ball, it's your target. Let's wait for the big ball and defeat that. Yeah, you can defeat balls in this game. And you're gonna get the 16th larval tier. We've got it. Now, two more to go. The 17th, it will be right here in this building. It's gonna fall down after you're gonna go a little bit further. Here we go. Do exactly what you just did with the first one. And the next one is here. Now the last one. Okay, we have a chest surprise. I just want to be a surprise. It looks something interesting right over there. Tell me in the comments, what do you think it is? Now, after you just got the 17th one, it's time for us to take the last one. We are right over here. Don't teleport anywhere. You'll just have to stay here. Climb the doors where the first ball just came down. And in this first building that you're gonna see, the ball is up there. You have to wait a few seconds and it will be down. You can defeat these enemies or not. The ball just fall down. Be careful not to die. And you wanna get your last larval tier, the 18th one. And now, if you don't know what to do with those, you can go to the Renalas. But let me tell you, you have to defeat her. If you don't know how to get to the Renalas, here are all 18th. I never used one. If you want to go to the Renalas, I have the perfect video for you. You can go right there really easy. and you have to defeat her. After you're gonna defeat her, you're gonna get a great rune and you can reset all your points in this game. With you have to use a single larval tier for every single reset. That's it. Thank you so much for watching. Hit that like button, subscribe and share, press the notification bell, and I'm gonna see you in the next one. Have a great day. Bye.